There is one more term here, which is not actually related here, but we'll discuss it here only and finish. Enomers we discussed. Next, write down epimers. Epimers. And all these, they ask question. Okay, so this is important. Definitions and all. Epimers, write down. Those carbohydrates which differs in configuration. Those carbohydrates which differs in configuration. Those carbohydrates which differs in configuration only at one carbon other than enomeric carbon. Right? Those carbohydrates which differs in configuration only at one carbon other than enomeric carbon are called epimers. Okay.
So, sir, enomeric carbon, the configuration is the same.
Sorry? Enomeric carbon, the configuration?
Is the same, right? In this case. In the
No. The thing is, we are not considering enomeric carbon here.
So, enomeric carbon, it can either be same or...
Basically, you can also say in another way that we are not considering the configuration of carbonyl carbon. The first carbon, C1. That we are not considering. Tell me.
So it can either be same or different. It doesn't matter, right?
Actually, one thing. It is written in the book that enomeric carbon, but actually, if you write that the configuration of carbonyl carbon, we are not considering. Because when I give you the examples, you'll see over there, like mannose and glucose are epimers. Okay, and there is no enomeric carbon present. So point is, you say enomeric carbon, it is written like this in the book, but just you ignore the configuration of the first carbon.
Okay, sir, understood.
Okay, that is the only thing you have to consider.
Now, basically, enomers are epimers at the first carbon.
Yes, that you are not considering. So when you see this example, you will understand this. You see, this also very important. They have asked this question many times. NEET. Maybe also they have asked this question many times. They'll ask you, these two are epimers, like this they ask. Suppose we have this molecule, and one more, let me draw this here. Okay. Here we have CHO. OH on the right, left, then right, and then right, and then CH2. This is glucose, yes or no? D-glucose. And this you let it be. See, there is no enomeric carbon here. We have OH this side. Only one carbon configuration I am changing. OH as it is, OH and OH. So can you see the difference here? We have the configuration differs only at which carbon? Only at second carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay. So this is D-glucose. This is, the name of this compound is D-mannose. Why D? The same logic, OH on the right. The structure is, the name of the compound is mannose. Okay, D-mannose. Now, D-glucose and D-mannose, what is the relation in these two compounds? These two compounds are epimers of each other. Why epimers?
Because they differ in configuration, but not at the enomeric carbon.
Yes, or not on the first carbon. These two are the epimers of each other. Okay. And since the configuration differs at C2 carbon, we also call it as C2 epimers. Clear? Yeah.
Yes,
so they ask this question. They'll give you the glucose and mannose are what kind of epimers? C1, C2, C3, C4, they'll say. Okay. Understood this epimers thing?
Yes.
Right. These are C2 epimers. Okay. One more example in this we have, write down D-glucose. And D-galactose. D-galactose are C4 epimers. Both of these questions they have asked in the exam. C4 epimers. So if you know the structure of glucose, can you draw the structure of D-galactose with this information? Yes?
Yes, sir.
So yes, for sir. Galactose, what would be the structure? At C4, this OH will be on the left and H will be on the right. That will be galactose. Am I clear?
Very clear, sir.
So you must remember these two points, that glucose and mannose are C2 epimers and glucose and galactose are C4 epimers, right? Next. Next, write down Haworth structure of glucose.
So what structure?
H-A-W-O-R-T-H. This structure is given by a scientist named R. D. Haworth. And they won't ask the name. Okay? Don't memorize this. Okay, Bharat?
Yes, sir.
And this structure is based on the structure of a molecule called pyrene. A structure of pyrene is this. One thing I missed here. Here in the ring, we have oxygen present. This is pyrene. And if you look at the structure, the cyclic hemiacetal structure, it is also a six-membered ring with oxygen in the ring. Yes? Okay. So when you draw the structure of glucose with the help of this pyrene, because it also has 5 carbon and 1 oxygen, similarly we have in cyclic hemiacetal structure of glucose. So with the reference of this structure only, the Haworth structure of glucose has been drawn. Okay? The Haworth structure of glucose is this. This is a 6-member ring. Okay? A 6-member ring. This is first carbon. This is second carbon. Third, fourth, and fifth. Okay? On the first carbon, because we have 2 structure possible here, where OH on the left and where OH on the right. Okay? So, all of you look at the structure of cyclic hemiacetal, alpha and beta. That structure you look first. In the alpha D plus glucose, the OH on the first and second carbon is on the right hand side. Okay? On the same side, basically. To draw the structure, what you have to do, whatever atom or group on the right, you have to draw it on the bottom of the carbon atom. You look at this structure. First of all, you see that cyclic hemiacetal structure. I am drawing this at this carbon. I'm starting this from the second carbon. from the second carbon. So at second carbon, you see, at second carbon, what is there on the right hand side? In the hemiacetal structure of glucose, what is there on the right hand side, you tell me, on the second carbon?
OH.
So this OH will write on this side. Like this we have. So I'll write down OH down and H on the top. And after this, we have alternate. Here we have OH down. Why OH down? Because OH on the right side. I'm just telling you how to draw this structure. You can memorize this your way also, but this actually helps you. Oh, second carbon, OH on the right, on the bottom. Third carbon, OH on the left, on the top. Fourth carbon, OH on the right, on the bottom. Fifth carbon, we don't have OH, but we have CH2OH and H. Okay, so we'll write down this CH2OH on the top because OH on the bottom here. So here we have CH2OH on the top. And this is the structure. And everywhere we have hydrogen. Clear? Did you understand this? Draw a six-member ring where oxygen is present in the ring and start with this second carbon. OH on the right in cyclic hemiacetal structure. Write down in the bottom and then alternate. Fifth carbon, we don't have OH, but instead of this, we have CH2OH. So OH on the bottom here on the fourth carbon. So fifth carbon, CH2OH on the top. Clear? Are you able to understand this?
So first carbon, is it both hydrogen attached?
I'm coming to that first carbon. So if you see first carbon OH on the right side, we have means on the first and second carbon, if OH on the same side, it is alpha. Yes or no?
Yes,
first
sir.
And second carbon OH yes, on the same side, it is alpha.
Right? Yes, sir.
So if I write down here like this, if I write down OH here and H here, then this is the structure of what? Alpha D plus glucose. Did you understand this? Am I clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you write this OH on the top, H on the bottom, then it will be?
Beta.
Beta D plus glucose. Draw that structure also. Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Tell
yes,
me.
Sir.
Tridib, Arvind, Ariman.
Yes, sir.
Devdas is there. Arya is there. Shaunak, Tridib, all of you understood. Lakshya also understood. Okay. Okay. What about? Okay. What about this? Paras. Likhit yes. Is there? Preeti understood. Paras. Likhit. Shreya. Samyukta Ardra. Tell me. All of you understood this? So how yes. Do we, write down this structure that draw six-member ring, oxygen in the ring, at second carbon, OH on the bottom, then the top on the bottom, and then CH2OH. Sixth carbon is not a member of the ring. This is one thing you need to notice. Okay? OH on the first carbon, if it is in the bottom, then it is alpha. If it is in the top, it is beta. Okay? So what happens here, you see, like I said, why beta form is more stable. Let me draw that structure. I'll just draw it here. Six member ring. We have this. I'll write down first carbon OH here, H here, then OH. On the bottom, H on the top, OH on the top, H on the bottom, OH on the bottom, H on the top, and then we have CH2OH on the top, H on the bottom, right? Alpha form, why it is not stable? Because when you draw the chair form of this, which is not required, or you can also see this OH and OH are very close to each other. right? So here we have diaxial repulsion. Here we have diaxial repulsion. I have discussed this in isomerism also. You can revise. Diaxial repulsion. And hence this alpha form is less stable. That's why in solid state or solid form, glucose exists in this beta form. So this is beta D plus glucose. These structures, we call it as alpha, beta, D. Another form of this is alpha, beta, alpha D plus glucose only we say. Since the structure of this glucose is derived with the reference of this molecule pyrene, we also call it as the name of this compound. The other name is gluco or glucose and pyranose. So this molecule, both of this molecule is glucopyranose. Clear?
Sir, what about even the beta structure? Is it also called glucopyranose or what?
Yes. That is also glucopyranose. It's a general thing actually. Position of OH, if you change, it becomes alpha and beta, but both of them known as glucopyranose. Even we also call it as alpha glucopyranose and beta glucopyranose. That is also correct. Okay.